Hey everybody, it's Josh Rogers with John Owen with Movement Mortgage. John?
Josh, how you doing?
Good, man. Okay, here's the question. How long does the home mortgage process take? And let's just talk in generalities now. Can you take us from day one to the closing? What's typical within your industry?
Absolutely. I mean, I would say you could probably see it on contracts as well. You know, some are 30 days, some are 45 days, some could be 60 days. And the whole pre-approval process could vary depending on lender as well. So I would say as far as a broad scale, it could be as quick as 10 to 14 days, as long as 60 to 90 days, depending on the company and lender.
Gotcha. So why does it depend on the company and lender? What's the difference, and what kind of stuff can speed things up or slow things down?
Absolutely. The stuff that can speed it up is how soon an underwriter can look at your file, because they're the ones that are making the final decision on the file. So it depends on how quickly a company gets it in front of the underwriter who's going to make the final decision. And a lot of times what that has is, you know, the documents that you need to provide to the underwriter, how quickly you can get those documents in, and how soon that company gets it to the underwriter. Those are the biggest two things that will delay the process.
And you've been in the industry for 10 plus years. How long does it typically take? Let's just say everything is provided on par. How long does it typically take to get everything for a regular mortgage company to the underwriter?
For your average company, and I've worked for, I've been doing this since 2002. I've worked for, you know, three or four of the major, you know, banks or companies, you know, in town. In most cases, what happens, as soon as a loan officer gathers all the documents that are needed, it goes to a processor. The processor then reviews all those documents to make sure that we have everything needed, and then it'll get sent to the underwriter. So in most cases, you could be 2 to 3 weeks into a process before the person that makes the decision on a loan is looking at it.
What's the pitfall? What's the landmine of that?
The landmine of that is, you know, you've gotten a shiny piece of paper up front saying that you're pre-qualified. It's got your name on it. It says you're pre-qualified up to $200,000, and you have a sheet of paper in your hand. You've used that when you submitted your offer, and you think you're completely good to go. Well, you just got to ask yourself, have I provided all my income documentation to my loan officer, and has an underwriter actually reviewed my file? The landmine that can go off is if your file is not being seen by the person making the decision 14, 21 days in to a 30 or 45 day contract, and they don't like your tax return all of a sudden because they just saw it for the first time, big landmine can go off. Now everybody's in panic mode, full blown.
And the whole deal blows up, and now you've already told all your neighbors and your friends and your family that you're buying this house, and now you're not.
Absolutely, and that's the worst phone call to make. So you don't want to have that feeling that you're good because you have a piece of paper saying you're pre-qualified or you're pre-approved up to this when you haven't really provided the documentation and it has not been seen by the person who's going to make the decision.
Yes, so this is where you set yourself apart, and what I really, really like. Tell me how Movement Mortgage and you operate.
Well, a lot of companies, and I first got to say that most companies, you know, will not even have the file sent to the underwriter unless the file is under contract. Without a contract, it will not be sent to an underwriter. That's, you know, the average standard. 98% of the companies out there will not send your loan to an underwriter because of the cost effectiveness. It's very costly for a company to have all those parties involved review a file without a contract, and they won't do it. So what sets Movement Mortgage aside is with or without a contract up front, I can have somebody fully qualified through underwriting, and normally within 6 business hours, at the most 48 business hours up front. So within the first 2 days of speaking with me and getting all your documents to me, I can have it looked at by the underwriter who's going to make a final decision on your loan. And what that does for you is instead of getting the pre-qualification letter saying you're approved up to this amount, you get more of a commitment letter, from underwriting that says you are fully good to go on the loan side. Now all you have to do is go get under contract, get a good appraisal back, and get title work back.
So you've reversed the process.
Completely backwards, and it makes complete sense, but like I said, most companies absolutely will not do it because it costs too much to have processing, underwriting, everybody look at the file. It's just, you know, very costly, and they won't do it. So they've decided to, you know, kind of build a realtor-centric and borrower-centric, you know, process to kind of eliminate that, you know, 21, 20 day, you know, into the process, then the landmine goes off. They want to eliminate that altogether because that's just a terrible place for all parties involved to be in.
Okay, I love it. And this is going to recap a video that we did before, but when somebody calls you, they found the house and they want to get a pre-approval and start the process, you can only work as quickly as they provide documents to you, right?
Absolutely. It's okay. I can run it through the automated approval system and give you the piece of paper. That's what you're going to get 99% of the time. If somebody runs you through an automated system, you just got to ask yourself, have I provided my tax returns? Have I provided my bank statements, my pay stubs, all the normal documentation that you would have to provide? And then also, you got to take it a step farther. Well, now that I've provided it, who's seen it? Because if the loan officer's seen it, that's the only person, you're still not fully qualified until it's gone to an underwriter.
Yep, I love it. Okay, everybody, so John's information is below here. Send him an email, call him. You know, we're both here for any kind of questions you guys have. Put your comments and feedback below. And as always, stay plugged in. We like bringing this value to us. Let us know if this is bringing value to us, and let us know what kind of topics you want to cover. Anything mortgage-related, loan-related in the country, reach out to John. Anything real estate-related, buying and selling, reach out to me. We'll catch up with you guys soon. Thanks, John.
Thank you. Have a good one.